Hello everyone. As we are studying the fluid mechanics through video lecture, in this COVID-19 situation, through the video lecture I am covering some syllabus. Already almost 2 modules have been completed. In one module, that is one very interesting topic will come. That interesting topic name is dimensional analysis. So the analysis, before to start, that means what the exact the methods of the dimensional analysis, first we will glance some basics that are required for the dimensional analysis methods. First one, mainly the dimensions are the fundamental dimensions. What are the fundamental dimensions? The fundamental dimensions are fundamental dimensions. The main fundamental dimensions are 4. One is, that is a mass here, mass, and the next one is a length here. Mass means that is a mass, and second one is a length here, and third one is time, fourth one is temperature. But this temperature we are not analyzing in case of the fluid flow problems. Means in fluid mechanics we are not analyzing the heat transfer or a temperature analysis. So therefore this temperature analysis is not considered in case of the fluid mechanics analysis. Here in case of the fluid mechanics analysis, fluid flow problems, fluid flow physical problems, in that cases we are considering 3 dimensional fundamental dimensions. Mass, which is represented as a m here, capital M, we are representing it as a capital M. Mass we are writing in terms of m. Length we are writing in terms of capital L here, and time we are writing in terms of capital T here. So this is the way how we can represent 3 fundamental dimensions for the dimensional analysis purpose. This is also called as the MLT form, MLT form. M means mass, L means length, T means it is a time. So next after this fundamental dimensions, next one will comes, there are 2 types of dimensions are there. There are 2 types here. 2 types of the dimensions are there. One is a primary dimensions and another one is a secondary dimensions here. What are the primary dimensions? Primary dimensions are nothing but these are the fundamental dimensions, M, L, T here. So primary dimensions are M, L and T here. Secondary dimensions are what? These are derived from the primary dimensions. For example what? For example, if you take a force here, force, how that force is, what is the unit of the force? The unit of the force is a newton. unit of the force is Newton. And how that force is defined by, how the force is defined, by which formula it is defined? The force is defined by the formula that is F is equal to M into A. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. It is Newton's second law. In this case, first we have to take at both the side that here M, mass. Mass means what? Here M. Here I will write this one in M. Into A. Acceleration means, what is the unit of mass means? It is in kg. Kg means it is in M. Acceleration means what? It is a meter per second square here. So in this meter per second square, we have a fundamental dimensions. What are that? M is there. M is the fundamental dimension for length. And second is there here. This second is the fundamental dimensions for time. So this one, this meter per second square, we need to write in terms of MLT form. So for M is a length, we are writing L here. And for second square, we are writing, that is the, in the divided by, that means it is in the denominator here. So it is, we are writing here T square here. This T square, it is in the denominator. If I take into the that numerator, this the power will becomes negative. So how this will be? M L T raised to minus 2 here. So this means what? This is nothing but it is a force here. This is a force. And under one side, this is a force F. F is a force. It is also having a unit is what? M L T minus 2. MLT raised to minus 2 here. So exponents, powers of M, powers of L, powers of T are same here. At LHS and is equal to RHS always here. So this kind, when the powers of M, L, T always they are equal, when they are equal, powers of M, L, T are same, then this nature is called as the dimensional homogeneity. It is called as the dimensional homogeneity. It is called as the dimensional homogeneity. So what we have studied here now, M, L, T, fundamental dimensions, two types, primary and secondary dimensions. Primary dimensions are MLT, that is a mass, length and time, and under the secondary dimension, the secondary dimensions, these are the derived from the primary dimensions. How these are derived, it is shown here. And if the powers of MLT at LHS and RHS are same, then it is called as the dimensional homogeneity. Likewise, we can write for any physical quantities, any physical parameters, we can write MLT form. How? For example, if I take is a mu. Mu is what here now? Mu is a viscosity here. Mu is a viscosity. What is the unit of the viscosity in SI? It is Newton second per meter square. This is the unit of viscosity. That is a dynamic viscosity in SI. So how to write the MLT form of this viscosity here? So how to write for Newton? Newton is what? Newton is a force. Already for force, we have derived here MLT raised to minus 2. Just I will write the for Newton here. So it is MLT raised to minus 2. And next is what here? Second. Second is for time. So it is only one. So I will write T here. Then divided by here meter square is there. Meter means it is a length. Fundamental dimension of that meter is length here. No? Here length square. Length square means it is a L square here. So I will simplify this for now. The powers of M, L, T only. So m is only 1 here, so write it m as it is. And next one is a TR2, one is having a power minus 2, one is having power plus 2. And minus 2 plus 1 is, there is a minus 1. So therefore it is the, so first I will take L here. L is having power here 1, and if this L square, if I take in the numerator, it will becomes minus 2 and plus 1. So L will becomes L raised to minus 1, and T will becomes also T raised to minus 1. So finally, the MLT form of the dynamic viscosity is M, L raised to minus 1 and T raised to minus 1. Likewise, we can write a MLT form for any physical quantity which are encountered in the physical problems of the fluid mechanics here. So another one, so here for especially for example for pressure or stress, for stress, pressure, and we can write, so what is unit of the pressure is what here now? It is Newton per meter square. So in the MLT form, how to write? Newton is here M L T raised to minus 2, and divided by meter square is there, it is a length square. So if I take in the numerator here, so it will becomes L raised to minus 2. So therefore for pressure or stress, all are having a unit, those who are having a unit of Newton per meter square. So this is the MLT form here. M is only 1, you write it as it is. And next one is L raised to plus 1 is there here, and minus 2 is there. So therefore M L raised to minus 1 and T raised to minus 2. So M L raised to minus 1 T raised to minus 2 is the MLT form of the Newton per meter square dimension. That is pressure, stress, like that here. So likewise, we can write the unit dimensions in the form of MLT form. It is very very important. We have to rightly know what is that quantity, what is the unit of that. This is a very basic. We have to understand how the pressure is measured, how that force is measured. If you know the unit, then we can write that means what the MLT form correctly. If you did this one now correctly, MLT form correctly for the parameters, definitely that means what we will write, you will solve the numericals on this dimensional analysis. Okay, thank you. Now I will stop. I will continue in the next video lecture. Thank you very much.